It is no secret that John Brown is a pioneer for modern metal guitar, so it's important that the intricacies of his playing are not lost in the mix. George shows us how he takes the already fantastic sounding guitars and then processes them to work well with the drums and the bass. Check it out and enjoy.
Right, so we've already got a volume thing to attend to here. Like that's averaging out okay. The first thing that I hear is like that range, like super it would be cool if it was food, it would be acidic. I'll try and over accentuate it. Those two EQ points are what I hear when going through that. So we're going to just try and pull some of that down using the what is called the insufferable mid-range filter, which I suppose sounds about correct. Need to check a different section now. So we need to take care of that low end blue. Thing that I hear is like what one can I use? I use this band here. Let's see, I feel like I can make this a bit, I feel like I understand why I had this tilt in place now. Here. I don't know why that grabbed that. Let's just turn that on now. That's already made a lot of sense. The cymbals are two up. Top end that I was talking about, this around here is too much. Ooh, and here. Let's see if we can bring in that ribbon mic then. Ooh, so what's happening there as I bring this in is it's slightly changing the low-end relation. Probably helps if I unmute that track, though. And the other thing that I did, which is on that photo, Nick, is that I used the fatso for the guitars. So let's see if that's correct. Okay, so the fatso is it's supposed to imitate tape, but I don't really know how much it does that. But I found that in this mix, it really started grabbing the palm mutes really, really well. So what's happening is, I don't know if Nick's got a photo up, but as the palm mutes are coming in, it's hitting maybe 2 or 3 dB of gain reduction. And then that's it. The rest of the time, it's just the tone circuit in control. And that's what I can hear that it's brought up the top end. So I feel like we need to do some filtering. But we're slowly building up a picture of how the band move, and then we can start adding in all the other trinkets and stuff. Still hear some acidity here somewhere. Let's have a look at how we're doing on how much is being clipped. Right, that'll change these big peaks like this will change when the BAEs come in, which we'll do after the break, and just hear how everything's holding. Do one last check against the reference and then see if there's any questions. Apparently, the guitars are louder than last time. I don't really remember that, but that's about it. I feel like we're in a really good, healthy ballpark pretty soon, actually.